Now let's talk about voiding invoices. You may have the need to void an invoice that a client does not want. So basically you need to get rid of it. And that's what voiding can take care of. Voiding, in a sense too, will, if there is resource pay tied to the invoice and the invoice has not yet been paid out to the resource, it will also void that pay as well. If it has already been paid to the resource, then if you need to take that money back, you would have to do a pay adjustment, a negative amount, on a future payroll to get that money back if you needed it. Now, to perform a void, what you're going to do is click on Receivables and select Enter Other Transactions. So what you're going to do is start off by clicking on New and selecting Void. So what you'll need first is the invoice number. So let's go ahead and input our invoice number and click the search button. Now what RB will do is it'll pull in the invoice information, as you can see, and you can see the actual balance, who the actual was the bill to client. So we're making sure that this is exactly the correct invoice. If you want to leave a remark down here, you can. So put, maybe we need to rebill this. You can put need to rebill. If you do not, if you do sales rep commission or client of commissions, these two checkboxes can be important. Normally, if we void the invoice, the sales rep commission and the client of commission will also void as well. But if you have a reason why you may not want to void the commission, then check these boxes and that will leave the commission for this invoice as good to go and showing up on the sales commission report. But normally, if you void an invoice, the commission probably will void as well. So you can usually leave those two checkboxes unchecked. Once you've made your remark, we'll go ahead and click save and then save and close. And with any other transaction that we do to finalize it, make sure you check the transaction and then always post as your last step. And then you'll get the successful message.